Father, we thank you for another day. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you, Lord, that you have kept us throughout the night and you've raised us up to see another day. You go before us today, God. You prepare the way before us, Father. And Lord God, we thank you that we are safe in the palm of your hand. We thank you, Lord God, for your amazing love, for your amazing grace, Lord. We thank you, Father, that you keep us from all harm and from all danger if we keep our eyes stayed on you. Father, let this word today be a blessing to us and reveal yourself to us through this devotion in Jesus' name. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Holy Spirit, lead me now and guide me in the name of Jesus. Good morning again. The title of this devotion is Look to Jesus. Look to Jesus. I'm reading a part of Hebrews 12. 1 to 2, the New King James Version. I've just read a part of it, not the whole verse. Hebrews 12, 1 to 2. Therefore, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which so easily ensnares us, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. Look to Jesus. Lay aside every weight and the sin that so easily ensnares us. Somebody might say this morning, I have no weights. Well, that's good for you because that means that you have laid them aside. But some of us are still carrying around some weights. Some of us are still carrying around some sin that we need to get rid of in order to run this race with endurance. And that is for those of us this morning. So lay aside every weight and the sin that so easily ensnares us. Sometimes there is some sin in our lives that used to be in our lives that would creep up on us and try to ensnare us again. That's where the devil will try to win us back into the world by the things that we used to enjoy as sinners. But we need to lay aside every weight and the sin that so easily ensnares us. The race has been set before us. My race may not have as many obstacles as your race, but we are running it with endurance. Ephesians 2:10 tells us, for we are his workmanship created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them. When I read this verse, you know, we read scripture, sometimes we don't really get what they mean until when the Holy Spirit is ready to reveal to us. And when I read this verse, I said, wow, God already prepared the good works for me that I should walk in them. He didn't prepare me first. Hallelujah. He prepared the works. He has his plan set out for me. And then he prepares me, hallelujah, to walk in the works that he has planned for me. That's why he has us there preparing us, molding us, shaping us, taking the clay and fixing us back into the vessel that he wants us to be. So he has prepared the good works for us that we should walk in them beforehand. Our good works have been prepared beforehand, and we can only walk in them if we look to Jesus. We cannot afford to deviate from the course that is set before us. Therefore, we need to drop the weights. Drop them off. Weights are distractions that will slow us down, but sin will stop us from running. We have to be able, I may not be able to identify your distraction because you are running in your own race, but I have to be able to identify what is the distraction, what is the weight that is slowing down my race. What weight is slowing me down? What sin is stopping me from running altogether? Looking unto Jesus, who is the author and finisher of our faith. Look to Jesus, not to anyone else. Sometimes we spend too much time looking at others who are in the race. We see their faults, but we don't see ours. We spend most of our day, instead of focusing on God, looking to Jesus, we spend most of the day looking for the faults in others, why they are not running in the race. But we should remember to look for the weights in our lives. Sometimes we spend too much time looking at other people. That's a distraction that slows us down. Sometimes we spend too much time looking behind our back, looking at our past. That's another distraction that will slow us down. Look to Jesus. Stop looking in your past. It's a distraction that the enemy is bringing to slow you down from the race. We know the scripture in Matthew 14, when Peter walked on the boisterous waves to go to Jesus. We often say Peter walked on water, making it sound so simple. But Peter just didn't walk on any kind of water. Remember, Peter was in a storm. And Jesus came walking to the disciples on the water. The wind was boisterous. That means the sea was rough. And Peter not just only walked on water, he walked on rough water. Hallelujah. Sometimes the water in your life may be rough, but you can walk on it. Hallelujah. The rough seas may be there, but you can walk on them. If you choose not to walk on them, then you may find yourself sinking. We can choose to walk on the rough seas and get to Jesus. Or we can decide, I'll just stay here and sink. If you find yourself sinking, if the waves are tumultuous, hallelujah, the seas are rough, that's the time you need to hold your head up and look to Jesus. Look to him. Sometimes we look to others and they fail us, but Jesus never fails. Look to Jesus. Isaiah 43 says, when you go through the rivers, they will not overflow you. But I can assure you that can only happen when we keep our eyes on Jesus. We see that with Peter. As long as he kept his eyes on Jesus, he walked on water. But when he looked at the boisterous winds, the scripture says he looked at the boisterous winds, he began to sink. You see, when we look at the waves, we forget our blessings. When we look at the way things are going in our lives, we forget to count the things that are going right. Hallelujah. And sometimes we say, what else can go wrong? And this came to me some day ago. What else can go right? We don't look sometimes at the things that are going right. We only look at the things that are going wrong. But if we look good enough, we can say, Lord, what else can go right? You are just blessing me so much. What else can you do, God, that would be such a blessing to me? You see, when we look at the waves, when we look at what is going wrong, we forget our blessings. We may not have a job, but God supplies our needs. We may have ailments, but we declare that we shall live and not die and declare the works of the Lord. We may be in pain, but at least we are alive to feel it. David said, I have been young and now I am old, yet I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. Philippians 4:19 tells us, my God shall supply all your need according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. There comes a time when we have to stop looking at the waves. Hallelujah. And focus on Jesus. Yes, the waves are there. Yes, the sea is rough. But if I keep my eyes on Jesus, I can walk, hallelujah, on this circumstance. I can walk on this situation. Hallelujah. I am not under the circumstance. I am walking above it because I have been made to sit together with Jesus in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Yeah, Shadna, hallelujah. Glory to God. The race may seem hard, rough, and tough. Somebody might say, you can say that because you're living good. You don't have any waves. You don't know what's going on in my life. But the thing is, I'm saying to you this morning, the title is Look to Jesus. Don't look at my life. Don't look to me. Look to Jesus. The race may seem hard, rough, and tough. Your feet may be sore, your legs may be tired, but as the song says, you never get weary yet. Keep running, keep looking to God, keep your eyes focused on Jesus. When Peter realized that he had lost focus, he cried out to Jesus, and Jesus reached out and grabbed him. Sometimes we got to cry out, no matter who's hearing us, no matter what they're saying about us, no matter where we are. We need to cry out to Jesus because he is our main focus. When we are walking on the rough seas, the circumstances will create fear, but we know where to look. We look to Jesus. The New Living Translation says he is the one who initiates and perfects our faith. The King James Version says the author and the finisher of our faith. The New Living Translation says he initiates and perfects our faith. We read in the word that he has given us the measure of faith. As we use our faith, it grows and matures. Even in the little things, we have to trust God. Run the race, looking to Jesus who initiates and perfects our faith. When we look to him, boisterous waves may be around, but check yourself. You are walking on water. Hallelujah. Check yourself. You are walking on water. Focus on him. And you will realize this is happening in my life, but I have a peace. I have a comfort. I have a strength. As the songwriter says, you are my strength. Strength like no other. It reaches to me. And when we need strength, God is our strength. He is our peace. He upholds us with his righteous right hand, but we need to call on him, look to him, focus on him. Hallelujah. You are walking on water. We know 2 Corinthians 5:7 says, for we walk by faith and not by sight. Hallelujah. We walk by faith and not by sight. Glory be to God. When we look at the waves, the things that can hinder us from going forward, that's just what they are. Things that are hindering us from going forward. Because the devil doesn't want us to go forward. The enemy doesn't want us to go forward. He wants us to look back. He wants us to fall. He wants us to stumble. But when we go forward, hallelujah, when we focus on God, when we look to Jesus, the initiator and the perfecter of our faith, we will go forward. If we don't look to him, then we begin to sink. If we look at our circumstances, if we focus and all our focus is on them, we'll begin to sink. But they can only hinder us if we focus on them. Oh, yes, they are there. We know they are there. But don't let that be your focus. Look to Jesus. No one has to tell us when we have lost focus. We can tell when we have become slow in our race or stopped altogether. We can tell. When we realize we are in the wrong lane, we have to refocus, call out to God in earnest prayer, and keep running the race. Don't stop. Don't look back. Don't go back. Keep running the race. Call out to God. Somebody this morning, your waves are tumultuous. The sea is rough. Oh, glory. But call out to God. Refocus. Don't look at the circumstance. Look to your God. He is bigger than any mountain that you can or cannot see. Oh, you don't know the things that he delivered you from, the things that you couldn't see. Yeah. The things that you couldn't see that he has delivered you from. So don't look at the things that you can see. He's a mighty deliverer. We can't afford to stop. The prize is ahead, not behind. Somebody tell the devil, I don't have time to waste. I am running with a purpose. I don't have time to drift. I must go forward. Contrary winds will blow. Some will be boisterous and the seas may get rough. But if we focus on Jesus, we can walk on every wave. Let us lay aside the weights. Some of us have more than one weight. Let us lay them aside. Lay aside the weights and the sin that so easily ensnares us, and let us run this race with endurance, looking to Jesus. Look to Jesus this morning. Whatever the circumstance, he hears, he answers, he will pick you up, set you on your way so that you can continue to walk on the waves. Father, we thank you this morning for your word. God, I pray that it has touched some heart. Somebody needed this word this morning, Father. And Lord God, I pray that you will stretch forth your hand and lift that one who is sinking. Oh, mighty God, we throw out the lifeline today, Father, for that one who is drifting away. Cover us with your blood, Jesus. We call out to you, God, as we lay aside the weights and the sin, for we must continue to run this race. We don't need the weights, Father. They will keep us back. We don't need the sin. It will stop us. So, Father God, in the name of Jesus, we cast all our burdens on you, and we look to you, the author and the finisher of our faith. You initiate our faith, for you have given us faith, and you perfect it. Ah, mighty God, I thank you and I praise you. As we look to you, Jesus, this morning, we give you praise. In Jesus' name, amen.